फ्रैनहोफर डायफ्रैक्शन, फ्रैनहोफर डायफ्रैक्शन एट अ सिंगल स्लिट मीन्स व्हेन द लाइट ऑफ सोर्स इज एट इनफिनिटी डिस्टेंसेस विद द स्क्रीन देन व्हेन द लाइट वेव फ्रंट इज इंस्टेंट ऑन द स्लिट इज अ प्लेन वेव फ्रंट. सो हियर इट इज दैट व्हेन द प्लेन वेव फ्रंट इज इंस्टेंट ऑन द दिस इज अ स्लिट व्हेन द वेव फ्रंट इज इंस्टेंट ऑन द स्लिट then secondary wavelets will travel like this parallel and this will be the screen. This will be the screen. So here the plane wavefront falls on a slit of width. Its width will be d small d. The width will be small d. And at every point, in each and every point will be small d. The width of the lens is slit is small d. Then wavefronts acts as a source for the second wavelets which is traveling from this wavelets. This will behaves like a, this wave front will behaves like a secondary wavelet source. Then when the light is passing through this, the intensity is distributed into the various regions means some of the maximum intensity and minimum intensity is distributed all over the screen. We can see in the screen this is the bright band is formed at the center when the light is passing through this when the slit then at the center of the screen this will be principal maximum intensity. Principal maximum intensity, the most bright band is formed, bright fringe will be formed. So due to this, the maximum intensity this will be the beside the maximum intensity, principal maximum intensity will be the this is a first maxima. First maxima. This is also first maxima. The less intensity, here is the dark one, black one will be dark, less intensity will be first minima. First minima. Whenever it is goes on, the dark bands will be increases because of the intensity will be decreases, so that the wavelength will be width will be decreases. Means when the intensity will decreases, then the width between the fringes is also decreases. Means wavelength decrease, if the wavelength is also decreases, then the fringe width is also decreases. So that's why here the intensity is distributed whenever the principal the first order maxima intensity will be I naught by 22 according to the practical values. That is I naught by 22, that first maximum value, and the second maximum value will be I naught by 61. I naught by 61 means secondary will be I naught by 61. I naught by 22 will be first, and the second one is I naught by 61. Here the first maxima intensity of I naught by 22, and here I naught be the principal maxima. Principal maxima. So here it is that from this any when the intensity is moving on this slit, then it is making an angle. Means in the different distance, first or second or eighth, first or second or whatever the maxima or minima is there, which is making an angle with the principal maximum intensity. Means light is incident in like this. Then if in case of this is the principal maxima, and first order maxima, second order maxima, whenever this is making an angle theta for any angular position theta, the intensity I is given by I theta is equal for any angular position. Means if in case of like this, this will be theta. Means first maxima, second maxima, or first minima, second minima, the intensity will be I theta is equal to I naught of sin alpha by alpha whole square, where alpha is equal to pi a by lambda sin theta. Means here alpha will be the distance which is taken from this slit distance, and also the distance from the values. Here this is a formation intensity distributed all over the slit screen. Means here this is the maximum intensity, and this is the first maximum intensity. Then second, this goes on decreasing. The intensity goes on decreasing, so that the shadows will be found at the center. The maximum intensity will be incident. Here the diagram which can be derived the principal distribution, intensity distribution. This is the center, which is I naught, which is having this maximum, principal maxima, and wherever goes on the secondary maxima, first maxima, that is I naught by 22 and I naught by 61. Here is also I naught by 22, I naught by 61. This is about the intensity distribution whenever the due to the, in the diffraction phenomena, when the light is passing through this, then due to the diffraction phenomena, the intensity is the total rays. First, the total rays is instant travel to the center of the screen. So that's why at the center of the screen, the all the rays are having the same pace. All the rays are having the same pace. So that's why it is, they should interfere constructively. They interfere constructively, superimpose on one another constructively, so that the maximum intensity formed, the bright fringe can be seen. So this is a intensity distribution. Next we are going to know this, the maxima and minima. Means here the diffraction maxima and minima values. What are the values? How do we define that? Simple diagram for the maximas and minimas of principal axis. Whenever the plane wavefront incident on the slits is divided into some of the components, these parts of the regions, all the rays is traveling towards the screen. All the rays are traveling towards the screen, and which is instant at a point, which is the total rays are having the same pace. So that's why here we can see the maximum intensity. This is called a principal maxima I naught. The distance from the slit to the screen is a d. If we want to know this hypothetically, we can use the some of the small technique by bifurcating that by taking the odd number of slit numbers. Then by taking this, the distance is classified into this. First, to know the first order minima, second order minima. Here, this is the first principal maxima. Principal maxima. From this, we want to know this. This is the first order minima. This is maximum, principal maximum, and this first order minima, which is having that periodically. So that's why here, the which is making the center lines, whenever the light ray is passing through the center, is making an angle with the principal maxima line, will be adjoining line is the theta. So plane wavefront is incident on this, then we can get this, the theta will be the angular. Theta will be the angle between the principal maxima to the whatever the minima we are taking, first order minima, second order minima, third order minima. We can derive the principal maxima and equations also. So that's why in case of this one, we can get a second order minima also, we can get that. From that, we can derive the equations. Let's see. So to know the positions of higher first order and higher order of maximas and minimas, we are going to split the slit. Means the slit can be divided into the odd number of zones. Then we can get there for the to understand the first order maxima, the slit can be taken into the three divided parts. Means the total distance from the slits is small d. The slit is divided, taken there, divided to three zones. From the one zone, one ray we have taken. So that's why wavelets are taken. So that's why here the Z1, Z2, Z3 means this is Z1, Z2, Z3. So three zones are taking. So the distance between each zone is d by 3. The width of the each zone is d by 3, because of the total distance is d. Then that is total divided into the three zones, that is Z1, Z2, Z3 of each distance having that d by 3. And the wavelets, the neighboring wavelets of Z1 and Z2 interfere destructively, so that due to the mutual effect, they can be cancel each other. So that's why the third zone causes the for the first order maxima. The third zone causes the first order maxima. So that in that case of the path difference between the Z1 of the top of the wavelet to the Z2 top of the, here the Z2 top of the wavelet will be equal to d by 3 sin theta, because of Z2 the distance will be d by 3 from the center. D by 3. So d by 3 sin theta. The path difference will be d by 3 sin theta between that Z1 and Z2. So that's why we are taking that here, the for the destructive interference between this neighboring Z1, Z2 neighboring wavelets having their destructive interference. So that's why here the position of the first order maximum, which can be take the path difference d by 2 sin theta, which is equal to the lambda by 2. Lambda by 2. So here it is that whenever we taking the d sin theta is equal to 3 lambda by 2 with the equation we can get. So from that equation also we can write that the second order means here the odd number of numbers is the 3 lambda by 2. Now the next one is that is a 5 lambda by 2, that is another order of maxima. Like that, in general further to get the maximum higher orders of maximums in the diffraction phenomena, which is from the single slit, the zone can be divided into the 5 parts. Then only 5 lambda by 3. Here we divided the slits into the 3 parts, so that's why we got that 3 zones says Z1, Z2, Z3 having that 3 lambda by 2. Whenever the slit is divided into the odd number of zones hypothetically, then we can get the easy to understand. So that's why here the 3 lambda by 2. Then in generally we can write the d sin theta, the path difference d sin theta is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. 2 lambda plus 1 into lambda by 2. If we substitute n is equal to 1, then we can get that first order. N is equal to 1 means the first order maxima. Then 2 plus 3 lambda by 2 means 3 lambda by 2 be the first order, mean path difference with the first order position of the first order. Then if in case of the second order maxima, the second order maximum, if we want to know this, then n is equal to, if we substitute 5 lambda by 2, we can get that will be the second order maximum. This is second order maximum. Like this, if in case of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, up to so on, we can get the all the positions of first order and higher orders of maxima by using this n dn sin theta is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2 formula. Like this, once again, to better understand the phenomena of position, to know the position of maximas and minimas, first we are taking that maximas means positions of first and higher order of maximas. So to know the maximas, we can split the slit into the odd number of zones. Here 3 zones are divided, that is Z1, Z2, Z3, each of width is d by 3. When the plane wavefront is incident on that slit, then we can take that neighbor wavelets of Z1 and Z2 are having the destructive interference, so that's why they cancel each other due to the mutual effect. So the path difference between the top of the Z1 to the top of the Z2 be the d by 3 sin theta. So from that equation we can write that d by 3 sin theta is equal to, we know that lambda by 2. That is the lambda by 2 is equal to d by 3 sin theta, the path difference. So from the d sin theta is equal to 3 by 2. N is where 3 is the number of slits to better understand that 3 slits are divided. So that's why you got the 3 lambda by 2, the first order maxima. Where the d sin theta is equal to 5 lambda by 2 be the second order maxima. Because if we want to get the second order maxima, then the slit must be divided into, considered into 5 zones, when then we can get that the second order maxima. From that, the general expression for the to get the higher orders of maxima is the d sin theta is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2, where n is equal to the number of order of maxima, means first order maxima, second order maxima, third order maxima, up to so on. The higher order of maxima we can write that by substituting the values, we can get the positions of higher order of maxima, which is happened on the screen due to the phenomena of diffraction according to the Fraunhofer's from the single slit. The next, positions of first and highest order of minimas. Here the minimas means to get the positions of minimas, to better understand, the slit can be divided into the even number of zones, means here we divided into the 2 zones, that is Z1, Z2. Z1, Z2 zones, so 2 zones are divided. Then whenever 2 wavelets of top of Z1 and bottom of top of Z2 we are taking that, then from that the angle is theta. Then the path difference between the slits, means wavelets, the top of the Z2 and top of the Z1, the distance means the path difference between the slits will be d by 2 sin theta. From that case, we can write that all the similar parts are having the same path difference. All the similar pairs are having same path difference. So that's why d by 2 is equal to sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. From that equation, d sin theta is equal to lambda, we can get. For the second order, this is the first order minima. For the second order minima, that can be slit can be divided into the four zones, means even number of zones, four zones. So then we can get the d by 4 sin theta. That is lambda by 2. From that equation, d sin theta is equal to 2 lambda. Like this. Same as for the general position of minimas is d sin theta is equal to n lambda, where n is equal to the number of higher orders of minimas. Means the minimum intensity of light is incident on the screen. To know the positions of the from the principal maxima, to know the positions from the principal maxima, then by using this equation, so we can get the positions of higher order of minimas. And even this will be the higher order of maximas, and this will be the higher order of minimas due to the phenomena of diffraction.